And Desmond here with Insane Bouncing on One Leg in Extremely High Places by Nick Sudan. Really can't help but feel we're really just stretching on game titles now. This is by the same guy that brought you Insane Joyriding on a Jet-Powered Bathtub Through Hyperspace with essentially the exact same play screen, and I'm gonna guess pretty much exactly the same gameplay with slightly different art assets. So let's... different stuff. Stage one. Then. Use left and right to tilt. Oh! I tilted too far. So, you're a guy balancing on one leg on a skyscraper. And that's the game. Okay. So this guy definitely has his own theme going on. And I kind of really do like the theme. Like, a lot. Dude. Don't get so risky with your leg balancing. Fuck! I thought I was gonna hit my head. Like, it did hit my head. Oh! Shit, dude. So I see you can, like, probably jump off. So, there's the difficulty. I really want to say something bad about this guy, because it feels like he's reusing something. And it's probably the thematics, but, like, I mean, I'm enjoying it, so it's like, how can you say something bad about something you enjoy? You know, fuck you, doggy. Do I get more points for jumping? Like a boss. It almost looks like he's not jumping when he's right there, because he's got, like, or not, like, steering on one leg. Oh, dangerous. I'm a boss. Oh! He slipped! Motherfucker. Come on. Did anyone really expect him to slip like that? Crunch. Alright, we're gonna do some physics testing here. Slide. Do the Harlem slide. Boss. Yes. Oh, bitch. Man, why didn't you just, like... It's like hacky sack. You're supposed to play it off your head, dude. Like a boss. This is a game within itself. It's far more entertaining as... Oh, I see. Like, after you, like, turn so far, it's just like... Like, he basically just assumes that... Yeah. Oh, shit. It's, like, bad how after... He assumes, like, after you turn so far, that you're not going to be able to recover from it. So... Just kind of, like, destabilizes your character or something. Oh, fuck. Here, I'm trying to show it, but... And is it just me or does the sky keep changing colors? Oh, I guess you can change back. Huh. There's just a little animation for when you go into the danger zone! I feel like I should be slipping off of this. Maybe it's a later thing. Oh! Don't do it, man! No! Extreme, like, leg bouncing on a skyscraper when the world's turning. Man, that bird shows knowing where it's going. Watch where it was going. Oh, yeah. How's he even jumping? He's like not even flexing his leg when he jumps. It's not human. Like, oh, whatever. Realistic physics here. I can't get enough of this. Just the physics are ridiculous. Shit! And just, like, slips on that very last edge. That got me so bad. Okay, I'm gonna try here. Oh, fuck. Alright, we're gonna get past the first one. wonder if I could. Oh man, I was just gonna try to swing really hard. Dude, these physics just like, and all these skyscrapers that look the same. It's a cheap use of our assets. It's parallaxing, and then okay, so he's got like one asset for the buildings that he just reuses and turns around, like two cloud assets, then the sun and the rays for the sun, and I think the sky just shit rainbow stars for a second. No. I should have been able to bounce off of him like a Goomba or something. By the way, there's a few clouded, different cloud things. Huh. But, yeah. And it, you can tell it's Game Maker. I mean, aside from, like, the fact that this kind of... Whoa, bitch! Oh, I almost had that. Aside from the fact that this kind of, like, rotation and stuff would be a lot, like, more of a nuisance to implement compared to other graphical elements. Game Maker is just retardedly simple. And you can tell it's like all super pixelated, no anti-aliasing. It's just, oh! Game Maker's love child. So, yeah. Let's try stage two. Wait, what did that say? I eat your dreams? Ooh, there's a stage three too, as well. It's like you're in Holland. Oh, why is this mountain so shaky? Why is it fucking goat? I'm gonna get over to the chimney sad. He just came out of nowhere. Oh man, goat. So, what? Shit. It's like difficult to do this without goats and shit, man. Why does he like rotate while he's in the air? As if like, see, he's just, okay, so I'm just gonna jump and not press any buttons, and you'll see that like when it's doing some extreme rotating. You'll see like he rotates like, oh, there's goats and birds. Okay. He does like extreme rotations in the air when he's not bound to any kind of physical object, which kind of like, again, physics. But like headbutted it. So like I said, I'm like really trying to figure out ways to hate this game because I can tell like on so many levels that this is like so cheaply made. But the sheer, how is this supposed to avoid both of those guys? The sheer joy, like, yeah, it's just like that. I mean, maybe there wasn't a way to avoid it, because it's, like, procedurally done, and there's, like, not any kind of search algorithm to see if it's actual possible to, actually possible to bypass the level, like, Cloudberry Kingdom. But, ooh, tiptoe balance. Whoa, trick balance, whoa, man. Anyway, so, it's like, really hard to hate this because there's just so much cheeriness to it. Let's see what it says. I pity your something dreams. Okay, stage three. Use left and right to, on a spaceship. Come on. Can I, oh man, that's lame. I was gonna like bounce on the tip, just to see how it feels. Just the tip. Alright. I like how, like, it's like, hey, I need this thing for my head so I can breathe, but don't worry, I'm not gonna lose all of my oxygen through my pores. Physics, what? I should have gotten 100 points, because it's a fucking asteroid, and I'm in space, and I'm on a rocket. How am I even, like, wait, gravity even? That doesn't make sense. This rocket has gravity. This is trip, eh? No, don't do it, bye! Hop. 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 Oh yeah, 10 points, motherfucker. Yeah. Boss. This kind of reminds me of NES. Shit! See, that's just not even cool. That wasn't even on screen when I jumped. How should I have avoided that? That is unfair gameplay. It's like Mega Man was unfair, but at least Mega Man was consistently unfair. Like, you would have to jump and guess where the next thing was going to appear, but at least the next, after you died and came back, it was always the same spot. This time it's, like, different. It's just impossibly unfair. Like, unless you're, like reading memory or something. Like, the memory of the game. So, I eat your dreams? I think there was two-player. Hold on. Alright, so I have a volunteer here to help me with the two-player. This is Brianna.
Hi.
And, I don't know. Let's see how this works. It's not going to be with the 360 controller, though. Okay, your arrow keys. Your arrow keys. And probably... Oh! Yeah. So, let's see. If I'm space, so you try... Maybe you're up. Or no. Enter, or space, or zero, or... Oh!
What are we doing?
We're modern yoga masters. What'd you figure out what jump is? It's enter. Yes! Boss, baby. So...
Oh, I thought you
were talking. Yeah, no. You can, like... flip around like a boss. Okay, so that did actually lock my character in place. Once you go past like 10 or 15 degrees past the horizontal margin, it will not let you turn back. Positive. Because I would have totally been able to do that, but
Yay.
It just wouldn't let me do that. So that's the kind of bullshit I'm talking about that makes this game that looks awesome
Woo!
A little annoying. I will... Oh man, it's like, I can't, like, jump, because it's, like, space to retry. But, yay! Oh! Twisted my ankle! I mean, I fell down some stairs. You're going down, Blue! Maybe we can, like, survive past, like, pigeons coming this time. Like, maybe jump over some pigeons. Ah, just! Yeah, you kicked that pigeon. Kicked that pigeon straight out of the air. I am perfect. T. I am perfect T. Whoop! Whoop! It's like... Wait. Why is my guy just like randomly turning like heavily compared to yours? Okay, bullshit game mechanics again. But, And yet, I keep coming back. Hey, buddy. Hold my arm. Hold my head! Hold my head! I'll save you! God! That is one terroristic dove. I'm pretty sure that's a dove, too.
It's not like a dove, but I would imagine pigeons would be more likely to do that, too.
No. It's gotta be a dove because of the irony in that a dove is a sign of peace, and yet it's just... killing us when all we want to do is, you know, stretch peacefully on top of a skyscraper while the world is rotating violently. Okay, so, I hate your... It's like it changes every time, and it's not enough time to read it! Fucking Nick. Dick. Dick Sudan. So, pretty sure there's at least one other game I saw from this guy, and maybe another one. Past that, I'm going to take a guess and say that the title screen is going to have a lot of rotating flashy stuff, and it's going to start with insane. But we'll see.